Well, with the some Everglades.
How y'all doing?
Good.
The private dancer?
Hello? 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 Hi. Please, there's no smoking. Courteous to our neighbors. Please keep your hands, your toes, all your belongings inside the boat at all time. Please do not feed any gators. If we see any gators, we might not see any gators. I'm going to try to make this as memorable occasion as possible for you all, because that's why you're here.
We might not see gators. That's depressing.
He's in a fight with his barber.
At least he made it to the Everglades.
Don't tell me what you might see, Jack. You're looking at what you might see. A huge fish. Looking more tumor holes. They might jump on and grab.
A fish. Like,
fish, yeah. It's
a I don't see any.
You around here, because this is where all the boats go. You get off this, I'll go in there.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Alex.
Here we go. A big fish just jumped up right there.
It's called Eldorado.
You missed him.
Eldorado was built some 30 years ago here, right at Holiday Park.
I saw the ripples.
Yeah.
It has to be huge.
Powered by two Cadillac motors, 1976 Eldorado, 500 cubic inch, 750 horsepower combined.
This is how ghetto our ship is.
There's a pump house and a lift gate. There are over 250 of those spread throughout the Everglades. That's part of the Florida Water Management District. The water we're riding on today is 100% rainwater. It is also our drinking supply, South Florida water drinking supply.
A reservoir.
Just to give you an idea of how big the Everglades is. 50 square miles, 500 square miles, 5,000 square miles. Going from Lake Okeechobee to Florida Bay. The boat you're looking at right there, the double-crested.
Thank you.
35 feet in depth. Built by the Army Corps of Engineers back in the 1900s. You see, back then, the Everglades was believed to be swamp. With those two small buildings that I showed you in the front, the pump station and the lift gate, they were trying to pump dig these canals, dredge the canals, and pump all the water out of the Everglades. Well, in later years, it was found out that they were not able to pump the water out of the Everglades because the Everglades was found out to be a river. It is known as the River of Death. It is also known as a watershed. It is the largest river in North America.
I'm on the largest river.
Here in the Everglades, there are over 300 species of fish alone. Another 150 species of animals, reptiles, birds.
Vultures.
And we also have an alligator right here on the left-hand side. Gee, look at that.
Oh, wow. alligator.
Alligator, take the front of the boat.
Oh my god!
Oh, there it is swimming. That is
so cool. Alligators are cold-blooded reptiles. They do not like the cold weather. Look up here on the left here.
Oh wow, wood vultures. Up there in the tree. Do you see how large that is?
He's huge. See that one up there?
Look up. Right there.
Right up there in the tree. There's an iguana. Oh my god, it's so huge. It looks really good.
Look at the birds inside the trees. Look at them all tucked in there on the branches.
Look at the iguana and alligator.
And alligator right here on the left hand side.
Yeah, there's a close up of the alligator for this live moment.
There are over 300,000 gators in South Florida, 1.5 million throughout the state.
Thank you.
Rock, is Organic, Muck, Lamac, and Quail Rock. A good majority of the evidence is very, very shallow.
Thank you guys for tuning in. I guess I'm not doing so well with the production.
This canal you're coming up to, it runs 25-30 miles straight down. A nest back in Texas, and she from time to time comes in and out. She would have wanted to live there 30 to 50 eggs at a time. Thank you. We'll see you.
Skips get deeper